Hello viewers, welcome to Learning Lane. Today's topic is malaria. Malaria is a serious disease. It affects millions worldwide. This dangerous illness is caused by a parasite. This parasite is spread through infected mosquitoes. These mosquitoes thrive in warm climates. Malaria is a major health concern. It can be fatal if left untreated. Understanding malaria is crucial. We must learn about its transmission, symptoms, and prevention. This knowledge empowers individuals. They can take steps to protect themselves. It also guides public health efforts. These efforts aim to control mosquito populations. By working together, we can combat malaria. Let's delve deeper into this global threat. Together, we can make a difference. Let's look closer at the malaria parasite. It's a tiny organism with a big impact. Understanding its journey through the body is key to understanding malaria. When an infected mosquito bites you, the parasite enters your bloodstream. This is just the beginning of its complex life cycle. The parasite travels to your liver. It multiplies and matures there, hidden from your body's defenses. After some time, the parasites change. They move back into the bloodstream. Here they infect red blood cells, which are responsible for carrying oxygen throughout your body. Inside the red blood cells, the parasites multiply. This disrupts the normal function of your blood. Understanding this cycle helps us appreciate the severity of malaria. Malaria announces itself through a range of symptoms. Recognizing these is crucial for early diagnosis and treatment. You might experience fever. This is often accompanied by chills. Headaches are common. You might also feel muscle aches and fatigue. These symptoms often mimic the flu. This can make early diagnosis tricky. Other symptoms include sweating, nausea, and vomiting. In severe cases, malaria can lead to life-threatening complications. These include organ failure and coma. If you experience any of these symptoms after visiting a malaria-prone area, seek medical attention immediately. Early diagnosis and treatment are vital for a positive outcome. Section 4. The mosquito factor transmission and life cycle. Mosquitoes are the main culprits behind malaria transmission. Understanding their life cycle and how they spread the disease is crucial for prevention. Only certain types of mosquitoes carry the malaria parasite. These mosquitoes breed in stagnant water. They become infected when they feed on an infected person. The parasite then develops inside the mosquito. After a period of time, it can be transmitted to another person through a bite. This cycle of transmission highlights the importance of mosquito control. By reducing mosquito populations, we can break the chain of infection. This involves eliminating breeding grounds and using insect repellents. Protecting yourself from mosquito bites is your first line of defense against malaria. Section 5. Diagnosis: Unveiling the Hidden Enemy. Diagnosing malaria is like detective work. Doctors use various methods to confirm its presence. The first step usually involves a physical examination. Your doctor will ask about your symptoms. They'll also inquire about your travel history. This information helps narrow down the possibilities. Blood tests are crucial for confirming malaria. These tests can detect the parasite in your blood. They can also identify the specific type of malaria parasite you have. Early diagnosis is key. It allows for timely treatment and better outcomes. If you suspect you might have malaria, don't delay seeking medical attention. Section 6. Shielding yourself. Prevention strategies against malaria. Prevention is the best medicine when it comes to malaria. Taking proactive measures can significantly reduce your risk of infection. Mosquito nets are your best friends in malaria-prone areas. They create a physical barrier against these buzzing insects while you sleep. Insect repellents are also essential. Choose repellents containing DEET. Apply them to exposed skin to deter mosquitoes. Wearing long sleeves and pants can also help. This reduces the amount of exposed skin available for mosquitoes to bite. Remember, staying one step ahead of mosquitoes is key to staying malaria-free. Section 7. Combating the disease, treatment and management of malaria. Treating malaria involves targeting the parasite. Anti-malarial medications are the cornerstone of treatment. These medications work by killing the parasites in your blood. The type of medication and duration of treatment vary. It depends on factors like the type of malaria parasite and the severity of the infection. Early diagnosis and treatment are vital for a successful recovery. They also help prevent complications. Prevention is always better than cure, but effective treatments are available if you do contract malaria. By understanding the disease and taking necessary precautions, you can protect yourself and others. Let's work together to combat this global health threat. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, comment for more videos. Thank you.